Is it red now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. Now, if you look here today, we're going to focus on this fine specimen. Ooh, it's been time to flip. Now it's time to put this in. First one. Okay, now maybe we can see what's going on. Oh, yes. It's taco time. Better known as taco time around these parts. Woo! 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 Oh no, taco!
Where's the crab?
Oh, okay, it's fine.
Why did the devil assign the chef and the cameraman?
Oh, what does today say? It says my toe is dead. Oh, yes. The Mimi is on the prowl. Hee hee hee. Oh, you're looking cute right now. Do not be afraid, the Tompkins does not have the ball.
Taco POV.
Corded.
You could probably charge the video cam though.
You can't. Because the battery,
look at my body.
Is fucked up.
It's freshly
shorn.
Appropriate for you. Look at this dance.
At first, I was a little confused because of the panel. I was like, oh, why can't...
Okay.
She's not into being filmed.
Okay.
Mm.
my face off a little bit.
So happy.
Bison burgers for house members.
Well, hello there. You look dark.
It's natural habitat.
Just quit my job 2 days ago.
Yay!
Yeah. Now I'm gonna try to live to the fullest of my potential.
Yeah.
Be free.
You're beautiful.
Yeah. And my mom's not even worried about me. She's pretty cool. She's like, what she said to me on the phone was, "You're a walking path." And yeah, that's one of the first times I feel like that she didn't freak out over some decision to make. I'm still trying to wake up.
Oh, hello. I didn't see you over there. DNA, what's the word of the day?
Pancakes that Jenny's making.
And camera now, Riz.
Hi, John's camera. Pew, pew, pew.
Kelsey is freshly back from the West Coast, as you can tell, I'm sure.
Woo! We got a tan line right here.
I'm zooming in on the tan line right now. You're beautiful. Make it cool.
Yes.
It's very revealing.
Oh. Good.
Did you left this cup?
Ooh. Done got stained. That's not a big deal. Hey, what are we about to do?
We're gonna go to the grocery store.
What?
Grocery store!
What?
Gordon, do something.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name's Jennifer.
What's your favorite color?
My favorite color is...
What do you look for in a mate?
Green. Meat?
Mate.
A mate?
Who's your favorite spice girl?
Ginger spice.
Do you know any jokes?
Too many. I can't remember them now. Mm-hmm. This is actually really... this is really exciting.
What's your astrological sign?
I'm a Leo.
Yeah, you're great. Thanks, Jennifer.
Yeah, no problem. Anytime.
Anytime.
Yes, as well. And that's the deep.
So, Kelsey, tell me about,
Is it recording?
Yeah, we're going. Tell me about, your...
Center of
your favorite dog.
It's like the meter's behind me. That means it's not mine, right? Oh no.
Hawk, Eddie, the Hawk, Hawkins.
Is that one of the sound?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, cool.
You just put a VHS in there and it goes. Chris, you should show us how beefy and strong you are right now. Why don't you go ahead and just stand up and, yeah, all right.
Sure. Okay. I was strong enough to break this.
Okay.
Rock that jiu-jitsu on the rig. Oh, yeah, dude. Awesome. It'll be like 6 days this week.
Damn.
They are working on opening up the two doors between the basement and the house. So see the stairs right there. This door has been sealed since we moved in. There's no knob. And it looks like they already broke down the wall at the end, at the bottom of the stairs. In the basement, and it looks like they're working their way up to this door right here. So, pretty exciting.
Are they wearing any protective gear?
I don't know. That's a good question. We should probably be wearing masks. But I think they are not. So, I am concerned. But we'll see what happens.
Did you
sons of the Holy Underground.
Any suggest we scoot this thing out of here? Seems to be what's holding it in.
Have you already taken all the hardware?
Yeah. Yeah, there's nothing outside here. Go away. Here we go. It's a lock. Hey!
Hey!
Oh, hey!
Did it. So we can see into the basement now from the house for the first time ever living in this house.
You see the light bulb we put in there?
Yeah, it's a brand new light bulb.
Whoa!
There be light.
Well, yep, pretty crazy. This is this is a new era, guys.
What? It looks nice in there.
It's not that bad.
I was afraid it was gonna be disgusting.
It was a little bit disgusting.
Oh my god, the door almost fell on me.
The door footage.
It's a door. Endorphins. Yep. Alright, well, that does it, guys.
Turn the fucking camera off.
Step two in renovation. Chris is in the details. He doesn't want his baby peanut roommate to get hurt.
No.
Very tender feet that everyone has here.
That's some fine work.
Stepped knee deep into mid squishmas right now. I can't really come very much farther, but the meals look delectable. Yeah, they should, yeah, that's good. They should dance together. There's Chris,
I wanna dance.
As he's known these days, as well as Jeff. Jeff Hubble. Let's get up close and intimate with the
She's important.
Dog.
Squish.
We got Kevin right here. I'm gonna zoom in uncomfortably close. Here's Jeff, J-Man, as I like to call him, you know, on occasion. Got the squish and spread right here. Got a squish and nativity scene over there. Marion, do you have anything to say for Squishmases from here on out?
Stop, drop,
and roll for the hawk.
That was great.
Yeah!
fraternity. With many people in other places.
Squishmas dance with the pie to the song that's being sung.
And hello, Mr. Hubba, thought of you about it. This is the Squishmas pie. Some apple pie with a bed of almond, ground almond, then finely, exquisitely sliced apples peeled by Hans here, then delicately placed in an oval, concentric ovals. The world is round. And then top with butter sauce.
Is anybody allergic to walnuts?
Whoa. What is that? It looks like
it's a Christmas pie.
Hubble.
Also, I mean, it's just
I don't know.
soup, it gets all puffy. You know, it's bursting out of its shell.
Yeah.
Sweet, delicious, nourishing broth. Yeah. Freedom induced. Peanut sponsored. For the well-being of all.
Cheers to that, baby.
Latest improvements at the house. This is not so recent, but we now have a compost system. We throw all of our stuff in here.
It's been about a year, buckets. Right?
Yeah, it's been over a year now. But yeah, greatly improves our trash situation. And this winterification that occurred today, this blanket over the door here, greatly reduces the air current. You can see it's nicely hinged on that door up here. It's gonna be a cold winter, gotta be prepared. And also plastic on the window. John loves putting the heater, the hair dryer on that thing.
Pastels. Thank you.
right, well, we're going to test it out live on camera. What do you have to say for yourself, Dana?
I'm pouring a beer.
Fascinating.
Live from Baltimore, it's pizza night. Do you want the rest of this? Here?
Oh my god.
This is our ham. Jesse's ham, actually.
Are you in favor of this?
Just, I like how you're keeping the pieces small.
Chris, do we have your approval to add this ham?
Yep.
You're a cyclops right now. One-eyed videographer.
Yeah.
He's like RoboCop, except less technologically, or no, Terminator, except less technologically advanced.
RoboCop.
Yeah.
Good. Do you want to come with me and get the first pizza?
And a sandwich. All the notes.
I actually kind of want to hear the smooth jazz version of that song.
It's a classic.
It's a Hall & Oates.
Here we go. Shake it up,
please,
baby.
Thank you.
Wow.
So, Marin, you want to watch me roll the next dough?
Omega?
Since you want to.
Chris, do you want to come for a dough assistance lesson?
Sure.
A dough tutorial?
I'm locked on the dough area.
Chris, come hither. Closer.
No?
Whatever, it's gonna stick on you.
Like flat eyebrows.
So you're just gonna keep adding little chunks of flour. And for the small slice pan, this is good. You just add flour to it so it doesn't stick to your skin. And then kind of stretch out the skin like that so you don't have any folds on the top.
Spell your Instagram name.
This baby.
Rub it
with flour. And very light pressure.
Light pressure.
I don't
know how to
say it.
Flour in it.
K-E-L-S.
Yeah.
You can also dip it over. See all the doughs that stick. It's a stretch bag.
Mega.
I kind of really like that. Boomerang.
Collect the dough. Flower.
Where are your gloves?
Where are my gloves?
Where are your gloves?
We have it a piece of pie.
And then you can transfer it to this baby pan over here.
Oh, you transfer it to a pan. Oh, you'll roll it in the pan.
Okay. Now you can ingredients next to these. Let's leave this here so we can cut this and eat it.
Really, this is really important.
Oh,
yeah.
Glue.
What do you say?
Glue?
You know, like what horses are made into sometimes?
That worked. Solved it.
Pizza beer party.
Chris, what's pizza times pizza?
Pizza square.
Pizza.
Square slices of pizza.
pizza.
Wrong, it's humans. First there was pizza and then there was humans. People have it all wrong. And we're going back in time right now.
So on it, like most public bathrooms, it's a koala and it's like a
baby koala.
But it's like a, this one was like a
kangaroo,
more like a parent koala looking thing. And the little kid was like, why is there a koala on it? To a mother, I assume, who's in there. And the mom was like, it's because it's the mommy and for the baby koala. And then you could hear the mom sort of slow down and be like, well, actually, I don't know why I said mommy. I don't know if that's a mommy or a daddy or whatever it is, but there's the parent. It was like the cutest PC, like, overheard in a bathroom moment ever.
So, at the Potter's Guild, we have to mix batches of glaze, and different people team up to mix the batches for the students. And we have all these recipes, and usually it's best if you mix out 10,000 grams if you're going to go through the trouble of mixing out, weighing out all the chemicals. It's just worth it. But somebody was doing like 3,000 or 5,000 gram batches, and Adam wrote, 10,000 gram batches, please. And Marion, ever the trickster, came in and erased the A and replaced it with the I, and that stayed on the chalkboard for like, I don't know, 2 weeks or something.
1,000 gram
bitches, please. I went unloading kilns. Please put the work next to the appropriate letters, please. And Marion, again, ever the trickster, came in and wrote IN. And
there's this pizza place in DC that basically get like a personal pizza in a box, but it's like a fast food place. I don't know. I'm not really that down with it. It's just like it's such like a waste generating operation. So they put like all these pizzas in their own individual boxes. I just think it's cool. Like pizza is one of those cool foods that, like, yeah, exactly. Very like communal.
Yeah, I feel like there are a lot of things that are you can get in like individual pouches that don't make sense. Or like individual sizes. I didn't look at the package for enough, bought a bag of frozen
for you.
Yeah.
Can I start rolling it?
Chris, what? You're the odd man. Oh, wait. I guess there's Kelsey.
Well, I saw the booty jiggle.
Thank you. call out the odd chef for dear departure. May his clear precision prevent future collisions. But hungry lion has plenty of clients who fragment the land so the belt may expand. Can slay on Mustang, on Taurus, on Windstar, on Civic, on Focus, on Prius, on Rabbit, on Cricket. Now, what I don't believe that all roads lead to Rome. When I don't believe that all roads lead to Rome.
The blizzard.
But we should move the cold nights down here.
Okay,
it's
so it's recording now.
Yeah.
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 Alright.
Just don't break your toe. Do not break your toe.
So how many swings do we get?
Two. One.
3.14.
Usually you get three, but that's also usually like a 5 year old.
Can I get a portrait of it just floating in the middle right here?
Not from under the
sinus. That looks so weird.
You gotta get the butt.
It's the left-handed Vulcan on your right.
The left hand of Vulcan.
There you go. That's more anatomically.
The left hand of Vulcan.
Oh, I get it. I'm reading that book right now.
All
right.
Well.
Spin around.
But you have to spin.
You're cheating. You have to spin. You can't feel it.
Here, I have to spin.
Okay, you can't use your right hand at all.
One, two, three. Good thing I'm left-handed, guys. Six.
You can't feel it.
Wait,
it's
eight.
It's big. Ten. Wait.
Okay. Don't hurt
there you go.
Because the point of the bat is you have both hands on the bat, so you can't.
So.
Are you spinning?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We should put her near it. She can't reach her from
other way for balance.
And that is
thank you.
this crazy letter collages.
That takes a very long time.
Do you want to explain a little bit what you're doing, Louise?
Sure. I am taking all of my mom's letters that she's written me since my parents' divorce back in 1994, and I am cutting them up and collaging them into new designs. So far, usually involving like a single Chinese character that either I shape together or that she has written herself. This piece is gonna spell out sound. So this is the top half of sound. And sound is actually two radicals. One which is li, which is to stand up by itself. And then the bottom half of the second radical of the word sound is sun. It's the character for sun. So that creates the word sound. That's what I'm spelling right now. Today I'm using the back of the letter instead of the front, because I'm getting a little frustrated with how busy some of these collages can look, and I'm curious what it would look like with a little more open space.
You also want to explain quickly what you're doing here in general, like where are you and what you're doing for this month of June?
Well, for the month of June, I started out by going to Vipassana, my first 10-day Vipassana course, which was really opening and really illuminating. And then I immediately came here on the 12th, and I think today is the 23rd. So I've been here for like 11 days now, almost 11 days.
Where are you?
I am at Holy Underground in Baltimore. I'm living in a house full of amazing people who are all artists and creators in their own way. And we've had wonderful dinners and talks and play music and meditating, which has been, I'm sensing into how powerful it can be to live in a community.
Where's the Holy Underground?
It's in Baltimore.
That's the right answer.
It's in Baltimore near Micah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's like, is it like South Baltimore? South Baltimore. Southern.
No, we're a little north of the train station.
Okay, right. Yeah. Yeah, geographically, I like totally do not have Maryland down at all.
Yeah, that's okay.
Baltimore down at all, but.
Cool, yeah. I just wanted to document really quick, like part of your process and. I wish we had done this with more of our past residents, but better late than never, so.
Yeah.
Starting with you.
Thank you.
Cool. Thanks, Louise.
Yeah, talk to Frog, too.
Okay.
Yes.
Hi, I was frantically panicking, I couldn't do so. Some kind of spell. He'd called you in, much to my chagrin. I wish that I had been fast enough to catch you as you fell. Well, then I'd have a different kind of story.
Here. Pew, pew.
glasses.
They're so cool. New magic floating glasses. Worn by Kelsey. Made by John.
Enchiladas.
Enchiladas. Enchiladas.
What's this step you're doing now?
You put the tortilla in a pan with a little bit of oil, and then you brush the enchilada sauce on each side of the tortilla. So that A, the tortilla softens so it doesn't break when you roll it up, and B, the sauce, like the chili sauce, soaks into the tortilla even more. And the flavor permeates the whole situation.
Permeates the whole situation.
Yeah. You have to permeate that situation.
Permeate the whole photo bombing situation.
Right. Beef with the red sauce, and then across the way there's... veggie ones with a green chili sauce.
It's our first month living here with Gina, by the way.
And Gina's making a big mess.
Gina's making a big meal for all the peanuts.
Thank you.
Also, James Andrews is visiting us. So, James, what's the latest update from this insane world that this film should know about?
Well,
the people watching this film later on, what should they know about?
Well, MTV is approaching us to be featured on some reality television show.
The real
Dragonfly, Dragonfly!
And
oh,
it's
wow.
about dragonflies and hipsters in Staten Island. Staten Island is obviously...
Are you talking about Insumi?
Point A.
Point A,
actually.
No, wait, no. You're making this up.
He's not.
MTV approached Point A.
Yeah.
This is a Dragonfly.
So I'm.
So Point A is like, whoa, this is crazy. And they're not gonna really do it, are they?
I don't know. I would like to propose that Insumi has two projects that I think are appropriate for a mass audience of young people like MTV has. One is Space Puppets, which is about a puppet-based cult of... it's complicated, but it's an alien-worshipping, puppet-centric community of people who live in the woods and who have these yearly rituals with giant inflatable puppets that they release to the cosmos. And they have special chromatic guidelines for the food that they eat, sort of kind of like color theory meets the palate. And there's a lot of symbolism in the food. And they have a lot of secret rituals, and they celebrate Halloween for 3 months a year. That's the first. And then the second project is to start a contemporary art gallery that's run by a cruel and unusual puppet as the gallerist.
Yes! I love that.
This would be like a hand puppet. So these are the two concepts that will be potentially put on the table for the folks at MTV Networks to think about.
How did they get tied into Point A people, though?
I don't know.
They're just like,
I'm
going to
be on MTV.
I'm going to search Facebook for community groups.
All right. Watch out, Mary.
Yeah, they're like, this is the next
oh, the whole damn enchilada's going in there.
Everybody's so populistic these days.
Point A should go to the Bernie part for all the people that are too afraid to protest, and they can start comments.
Real star of this movie. She's in almost every scene. She's the main character of The Hole in the Ground.
Mimi.
Protagonist. Everyone loves her. She hates everyone. She loves everyone too, though.
Heart!
You do ball bunions!
Elephant heart!
Crowd. There's just one short video of this weird kid who got camera pointed on him one day, and he just goes crazy, and he's like showing his nipples, and he's like, that's what I thought of. So.
Nipples.
Way inaccurate.
There's another one of those that was circulating recently.
Oh, yeah, that one's not nearly as crazy.
These memes of the month?
I'm gonna find these.
start serving yourself.
No eating. I'm an innocent boy of some sort, and
it's Frog. So, Frog, tell us about your residency. Do you want some more specific questions, or do you want to maybe
sure.
do some general things first and then...
Okay, let me try to answer that first question.
Okay.
My proposal was to decorate the front window, and I wanted to combine two projects that I'm working on. One is the puppet show that is loosely based on a children's book called The Color Bird, and the other one is these artifacts of Donghua, from Donghua studies, particularly the funeral scroll, the road to heaven. So I was wondering if I think of the color bird as a Taoist story that keeps looping on itself, but the road of heaven is this path that goes from dark to light and then it ends, I think. So I wondered how I could possibly combine the elements in a way in the window while the things are moving in the window. And then it's organically just grown into this thing where I'm making drawings of 8 lucky symbols. The symbols are called Ashtamang Mangala. Do you want to see the whole thing or just part of it?
Yeah, why not?
All right, it is long. So that is 9 black mountains and rivers with the guardians, like demon guardians, and the priest would, at the funeral, the priest guides your soul up through those mountains. This is the gate of hell, that's a bow, and then here's where all this torture happens, many stages of torture. Here's the window, two musicians and lucky things that hint to earth, and this one panel is earth and humankind. And if your soul is meant to reincarnate, you go through this square bullseye with a flower. So your soul would go through here. But if it's meant to just keep on going, then you come up to this gate of heaven, and you keep going up. The further up you go, the more you see people meditating.
The door is hiding you. Yeah, it's quite long.
Well, maybe you should come over and see the final panel.
Okay. So, do you want to tell us about some of these best images, Frog?
Well, it just comes up this way, and these figures, these deities are meditating. This panel is binary gender, one male, one female. This is Sayi Wida, which people sometimes think is a woman, but I think most have referred to it as a man. And this last panel is a flower that represents nature. And it's sort of like that. Being the final panel is also a panel of rebirth.
The symbols you were
sure.
talking
just
about
I'll
earlier.
Do a really quick slideshow.
Mm-hmm.
This is the order that I've presented them in the window. Purification tool and ritual
where you pour in water here, you put a piece of gold or silver to activate cleansing of the water. You can put flowers or peacock feathers on top right here. And then that goes on the altar table that then purifies the situation. And I did some screen printing. This was unrelated to the residency proposal, but it was a fun thing I ended up doing. It's like collaboration with Rain. Who are the other ones? These two are Dongba symbols. This is Shochu, which is the Garuda figure, half person, half bird. And here's a flying snake. And this is the symbol for good looking. It's a human face with a flower in the center. Yeah. And I think there's one more. This wording thing that Rain and I also collaborated on. Where is it? Maybe it's gone.
So Frog, maybe you can tell us about your general experience here at the Holy Underground, you know, personally, how has it been for you?
General experience?
Yeah, how long have you been here?
I've been here a month this time, but I was here also for 2 weeks in 2014, and I've known everyone who lives here for a little longer than that. Been really fantastic so far. One feels like family. I really enjoy meals we have together or just crossing paths randomly in the day. I think the energy here is really good. I'm grateful to have this room that gets really great light and the company of the plants. And the location is great.
Do you want to tell us? Sorry. Uh-huh. Do you want to tell us a little bit about the Bell Foundry and your friends there? Because you've been going over there a lot, so they sound like an awesome group of people.
Mm-hmm. I was there for a little bit before I got here this time, and since they have a print shop there, you can use it for free as long as you clean up, respectful of the materials. So, working on these prints, I've been going back and forth between here and there. This time. I felt really impressed with both places having a successful model of communal living. One place having around 8 people, right? This place has 8 people?
Seven.
Seven.
Well, right now, with you and Louise, there's 9, but normally it's 7. But it's been more and it's been less in the past. It kind of fluctuates.
It's a little different there, I think, because the group is bigger. But it's sustainable, and they've been around almost 10 years. And this place is going on 5 or 6, right?
We just entered our 5th year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So.
Cool. Well, thanks, Frog.
Thanks, Yenny.
Yeah.
It's kind of black and white. Is it black and white?
Later on it's in color.
Oh.
But
right, you get the folding table.
And then you get the comments, and that's where,
you
like,
get the folding table.
And I think that actually it's actually very useful to other people. And you never heard anyone ever talk about
it. I think that there are a few colleges that have, like, banned Greek culture.
Yeah, well, that's because of the body count. I mean, people are dying left and right. There was an amazing article. In fact, if you made a time capsule and tried to explain America to alien races or whatever, one of the most useful articles you would ever want to include in a time capsule is this incredible expose, like a massive feature article, I think in Rolling Stone, about the phenomenon of people in frats rolling over in their beds and falling out of windows to their death.
Oh my God.
What are you talking about?
just our inner confidence and our inner motivations and our willingness and ability to be open to connect with synchronistic events, such as, you know, because I think once we put intentions like this out and start to claim our intentions in a more verbal, real way with these acts and words, then we are opening ourselves up to receiving our future, basically, that we're asking for with these words. So when we do that, then we can open ourselves up to synchronicity, events, which I believe are just sort of when things syncing up. It happens all the time to everyone, whether or not we want it to, but when we ask for certain things and we open ourselves up to the universe, we become much more available for synchronistic events that get us much closer to our goals, much quicker, and in much more creative ways than maybe we would even think of for ourselves. So, for example, if you're asking for a job or a certain career path that you'd like to go for, and you start doing intention work with it, you know, whether or not it's aligned with the moon, but when we put it out there that that's what we want, I'm trying to think of an example. Like, I want to be a teacher. I'll just put it that way. So I want to be a teacher. I don't know where. I just know I want to do it. Or I know that I want to teach at this school. It can be really specific. When you open yourself up to the possibility of it happening in ways other than you've laid out for yourself, for example, apply, you know, interview, and wait, basically.
Dog's trying.
Don't want pictograms on that bus. It says, "Lead down to the..." like a Broadway kind of version of. This is, I think, the most expensive luxury hotel that opened in Legion. So I think this stuff seems really exotic and new, too, as of the past 10 years. So, if you're from a farming village, you get a desk job at this kind of place, everyone's really proud of you. And no one wants their kids to become a farmer or a dungwa. So what do people do? And currently, a lot of dungwa now are terrible alcoholics. Like, they used to work for alcohol or rice or meat.
For alcohol. I just meant, for any sort of, thing that all the dungwa is like.
They safekeep religious knowledge for their community. So a person can be one or the other or both. And I think most people have agreed that dongbas are sort of shaman hyphen priests. And sort of lightly practicing things that I can relate or agree with. And because I kept asking what happens if a woman practices dongba, and sometimes I can identify as queer with gender changes. But they're not really having that kind of conversation right now in that region. They view me as a woman who is doing a really weird thing by being interested in dongba. And people have been encouraging, though. They're like, if you're so interested, just keep going. And we'll just see what happens. Blue is kind of neutral. It's in Chinese symbology. And I also just draw from observation.
I need to do that.
You're into this?
Yeah.
So you use something useful while everyone's on the move. And so it doesn't matter your gender, women can practice shamanism too. Okay, so you have a shaman on your cell phone.
A few months ago, out of my mom's letters. So these are all my mom's letters that I've saved from 1996. My folks divorced when I was 9. So in 94, my mom moved away from California and started to write me letters, way before email and text and line and everything. So I've saved her letters over the many years, and in 2010, I had an apartment fire in Brooklyn. So I've been living in New York City since 2003. And in 2010, in my apartment in Brooklyn, I had a 5-alarm apartment fire. And that was actually, our apartment was actually apartment 9. So it was the 2 out of 10 units that still had recoverable things. Wow. Everything else was just a huge pile of rubble on the ground. So for 2 hours, I got back into my apartment, and my mom's letters was weirdly one of the things I decided I would bring out of the place. And they were all incredibly water damaged. The first two that would probably go here if I had them here. I actually started out wanting to do stained glass. Like, I have this idea to make Chinese, to represent Chinese characters in stained glass. And right around when I was karmaring my apartment, do you guys know what karmaring is? Karmaring is this decluttering practice started by this Japanese woman, Marie Kondo. And her practice is you take any object in your house and then you just ask yourself, does this spark joy in my heart? So it's a constant practice. It's a heart-based practice of declutter. And I finally got to my mom's letters and I was gonna burn them, but then my friends were like, what if you made something out of them?
Why would you burn your mommy's letters?
Because there was a lot of because it felt right, and also because it felt like I value my relationship with my mother as it is now. And there was just a lot of information in there that that didn't feel like it was aligned with what I needed now.
The Adventures of Mimi.
Waiting there. It's like a still life, they're just waiting there to be addressed. So this is called Between Them. I hear the door sound. Between Them. One rippled and half peeled from the mattress, the other a ridge rumpled at the base of the bed, starched by salt. Waiting to be uncreased by evening. A poetry class I took where we took a foreign, non-English foreign poem, and then just listening to the phonetics, interpret the words in English, and write something. So this is my homophonic translation. So this first one, called Truth and Consequences. Blatant disregard lays espoused key sorrow deep, my soul at my loom. And now the next one. I actually called Spring Break, may as well be here, but I think I could have just called it To-dos in font, allays morale, crayoned leisure, languid we.
What you're familiar with is Travel by Haiku, volumes 1 through 5, still tripping across the states. And it's a collection of haikus that are kind of scary sometimes. Also very, I hope at least one of them is that like perfect Zen haiku where you like read it and you're like, damn,
he got it.
Damn, he got it. Damn, he nailed it. That's like when I read a good haiku, that's how I react. I usually throw the book across the room. Or any good poem, really. The other thing I'm going to read, and I'm going to start with that first, is in my time out west, there's a lot of other things that happened before this most recent wave of
darkness. I'm not sure if you guys are all aware of what Standing Rock is, but if you aren't, Standing Rock is it's a reservation in North Dakota, the Lakota Sioux tribe, that basically for the last year, pretty much since I left the East Coast in April, has been fighting off a pipeline that's trying to be built not only through their main water source, the Missouri River, but right through their sacred lands, the lands that were signed over to them in a treaty in the 1800s. There's burial sites, there's sacred sites, there's all sorts of just pieces of their heritage that are on these lands that have been already bulldozed through during the construction of this pipeline, but also some have been fought off. But it's definitely been a pretty pretty intense situation. And living in Taos, I was definitely connected with the indigenous culture of that area, and there's definitely like a high vibe of lots of support going up. There's caravans going up every week. In Taos, we have a pueblo that is about 10 minutes outside of town. It's been there forever. It's the longest inhabited structure in this country. People have been living there since about 1100 AD. Of course, people have been living in that area for thousands of years, but then this pueblo has been inhabited specifically since 1100 AD and consistently, nonstop. It's also a really interesting reservation where they were the only, I think they were one of the only ones in the country where they were able to maintain their hunting grounds and also their water source in a treaty that actually stuck instead of being surrendered or backstabbed like 2 days later or something like that. But with that culture surrounding me, I did have a lot of I was feeling called. I'm a nature boy, so I was feeling called to North Dakota already. But there was definitely a lot of support that I was called to do in Taos, and then I ended up catching a caravan up to North Dakota and spending about a week and a half in at Standing Rock. So I'm going to read some essays from my experiences up there. And as I read them, I don't want you to see me as like a face of the movement. I'm a white male, I'm Irish American. The movement, Standing Rock is an indigenous movement, and that should be what you think about when you guys hear these essays. And that's what I'm going to talk about too. I mean, I'm going to talk. It's not usually, I guess, a lot of you who have seen me perform before. I mean, I'm always talking about these rambling journeys that go on. So these essays are more about just kind of, I guess, showing like the reality that I saw and observed, that if you've been paying attention, maybe you don't see in the news. Or before I went up, I was paying attention. I was watching a lot of the live feeds, and a lot of live feeds are great because they really like hurt you. They like put you there. You're right there as your indigenous relatives are being maced in the face, or now they're shooting water cannons at them. Actually, at this moment, I think things have kind of like slowed down just because there's a blizzard, so that's even more intense. But right before the blizzard hit, they were shooting water cannons at people in like 18 degree weather, and wow, it's pretty fucking intense to watch. It's pretty like wow. I mean, I know it's 2016 and that's a terrible year, but it's 2016. Like, what the heck is going on? Ever since I traveled to Ireland in July, I haven't stopped thinking about my bloodline. It was maybe a couple weeks after I got back to the States when the bulldozers started rolling through sacred sites, including burial mounds and cairns and other human-made formations in North Dakota. The pain this gave me is indescribable. I'd just been to a tiny island of a country filled with similar cairns and ring forts and burial mounds and druid rock circles preserved for thousands of years, some since 5000 BC, initially out of fear, but then out of a reverence for a people's past. Some of these were registered as World Heritage Sites with UNESCO. But most of these sites were in people's backyards or on a farming family's land, and no one touched them for that entire period of time. Not with a tractor, not with a shovel. None of the stones were displaced or removed in all this time. Yes, the Irish are a superstitious lot. If any of them had come along and removed a single stone, they would have had a penance to pay with those fairies. that would have struck them down. But this fear eventually translated into a sort of respect. In a few days, I'll finally be traveling to North Dakota to pay my respects to a people that have been so disrespected in the past 500 or so years since the European invasion of 1492. I consider these folks family in so many different ways. I am not a First Nation person, but I relate more to the roots of this continent and the roots of my own tribal heritage than anything that has come along since then in the way of thought. Western society is cruel and sadistic. I've always found a separate peace in the earth and the moon, the sacred mother and her luminous sister, the way the trees grow tall and the wind brings simple wisdoms. It is 2016, and it is about time the people of this current nation make a stand. No to industrialization. No to petty jobs for petty wages. No to digging up death to stunt the growth of cleaner and safer technologies. No to genocide. On Monday, I'll leave the Tiwa land to go support the Dakota land. I'll find folks from all over the world there. Together we'll be rising up, but really we'll be supporting each other to get there. We'll be friends, allies, friendly. Our hearts, which are all made of the same earth, will guide us. On the surface, we will be defending the earth against sadistic tyrants who seek to ruin us all for profit. In a much more radical way, we'll be ending a centuries-long war against the people that were here since the dawn of time. We'll be defending their culture, their heritage against invasion, so that they can again walk upon this land and teach us all how to celebrate this existence. I watched a crow fly into the Pueblo ruins and come out a man. Arches as windows or portals to spirit worlds and ancient timelines. The mysticism of now, trapped forever in desert paradise. Their arms held outstretched. Yucca are like young Shivas, dancing in the desert flames.
I think it could be either or. So yeah, here we are at the Holy Underground. It's the day before New Year's Eve. Do you guys have any advice for our future selves, like when we watch this a year, 2 years, 10 years from now?
I feel like I need my 10-year self to give me advice, not my this year self to give me advice.
Nice.
Talk to me
in
10 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. Focus on joy.
Focus on joy. Okay, that's good. Yeah, and there's no obligation on anybody's allowed to speak.
What about you?
Congratulations, Chris, on your black belt.
Yeah. Ooh. Yeah, ten years
from
now.
Chris.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Second bat.
I think that's good advice, Kate.
Congratulations.
What about you?
On your thriving arts business, selling dolls and pottery.
Yeah,
the cult following you developed is amazing.
It's outrageous. I think something good to think about is look back on this moment now and think of how far you've come, you know, in 10 years or have whatever amount of time. You know, if you're unsatisfied with where you are, you know, think of how much progress you've made.
Mm-hmm. Was it advice or congratulations? Can I miss
it? It can be whatever you want.
It was easier to...
I'm gonna tweak this a little bit because I think that if the 5 years ago me took inventory of the present me, I'd be really relieved and relieved, number one, and happy and proud, and I would know like what was I so worried about all the time. So
I think
my future self is going to like look back at this self and say my advice from the future, or I don't even know how to what the context of this is, but
past.
Yeah. So I guess I would say to always just trust that the universe has you, and when you let go of the anxiety, things fall into place.
Listen how it grows.
Yeah.
When you call.
Crystal, Bjork said it. It's gotta be real. Real if Bjork said it, you know.
Yeah, she knows what's up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good job, guys. I'm being your past selves, your present past selves.
Thank you.
That's so true.
A glass of wine, the lights are dim.